Hello students, welcome to e-classes of P.N. Amarse High School. We will continue with our chapter number 11, Algebra. Now let us begin with our exercise 11.5, question number 1. State which of the following are equations with a variable. Give reason for your answer. Identify the variable from the equations with a variable. Students, here we have to state which of the following are equations with a variable. Then we have to give reason for our answer. And then we have to identify the variable from the equation with a variable. Now solution for question number 1. A part of question number 1. 17 is equals to x plus 7. Here first we have to state whether this is equation with a variable or not. So it's an equation because it has a variable x and it has the equality sign. So students, here you can see, here this expression has a variable x and there is an equality sign. So it's an equation. B part of question number 1. T minus 7 is greater than 5. We have to state whether this is an equation with a variable or not. Here the answer is it is not an equation. The reason for it is because it does not have equality sign. It has a greater than sign. Student, this is not an equation with a variable because it has a greater sign. It doesn't carry equality sign. So the answer is it's not an equation. Third part of question number 1, 4 upon 2 is equals to 2. Here also we have to state whether this is an equation or not. It's not an equation. The reason for it is because it does not have a variable. Students, here you can see the expression doesn't carry any variable, so it's not an equation. D part of question number 1, 7 multiplied by 3 minus 19 is equals to 8. Here also we have to state whether this is an equation with variable or not. So the answer is it is not an equation. The reason for it is because it does not have a variable. This expression doesn't carry a variable, so it's not an equation. Students, remaining question number 1 of exercise 11.5, you have to do it by yourself. Question number 2, complete the entries in the third column of the table. Students, here in the first column numbers are given, in the second column equations are given, and in the third column value of the variable is given, and in the fourth column we have to write equation satisfied yes or no. A part of question number 2, 10y is equals to 80, where the value of the variable y is 10. We have to state whether the equation is satisfied or not. Solution for A part of question number 2 here. 10y is equals to 8, it was given in the table where the value of variable y is 10. Now we have to use 10 in the place of y. So here in the place of 10 multiplied by y, we will write 10 multiplied by 10. In the place of y, we will write 10. So 10 multiplied by 10 is equals to 80. If we multiply 10 by 10, we will get 100. So 100 is not is equals to 80. Therefore, the equation is not satisfied. So here students, we will write no. If the value of the variable y is 10, then 10y will not be equal to 80. So equation is not satisfied. B part of question number 2, 10y is equals to 80, where the value of variable y is 8. Now B part of question number 2, where it was given in the second column 10y is equals to 80 and the value of variable y is 8. Now in the place of y, we will use 8. So in the place of 10 multiplied by y, we will write 10 multiplied by 8. 10 multiplied by 8 is equals to 80. By multiplying 10 by 8, we will get 80. Therefore, 80 is equals to 80. So the equation is satisfied. So students, here we will write answer as yes. If the value of the variable y is 8, then the equation 10y is equals to 80 is satisfied. Now C part of question number 2, you have to do by yourself. Now D part of question number 2. 4L is equals to 20. If the value of the variable L is 20, we have to find out whether the equation is satisfied or not. Now solution for D part of question number 2, where the equation was 4L is equals to 20, where the value of L was 20. Now in the place of L, we will write 20. Here in the place of 4 multiplied by L, we will write 4 multiplied by 20 is equals to 20. This 20 we will bring down here. So 4 multiplied by 20 is 80 and 80 is not equals to 20. Therefore, the equation is not satisfied. Now, students, if the value of variable L is 20, then the equation 4 L is equals to 20 is not satisfied. So here we will write no. Now, E, F part of question number 2, you have to do by yourself. Now, G part of question number 2, where B plus 5 is equals to 9 and the value of B is 5. We have to state whether the equation is satisfied or not. Solution for G part of question number 2, where B plus 5 is equals to 9 and the value of variable B is 5. Now, in the place of B, we will write 5. So, 5 plus 5 is equals to 9. And if we add 5 plus 5, we will get 10. So 10 is not equals to 9. Therefore, the equation is not satisfied. So students, if the value of B is 5, then B plus 5 is equals to 9. The equation is not satisfied. So here we will write no. Now, H, I, J, K part of question number 2, you have to do by yourself. Now, L part of question number 2, H minus 8 is equals to 5. The equation given in the table is H minus 8 is equals to 5. Where the value of H is 0. We have to state whether the equation is satisfied or not. Solution for L part of question number 2, where in the table it is given that H minus 8 is equals to 5 and the value of variable H is 0. Now in the place of H we will write 0. So H minus 8 means 0 minus 8 is equals to 5. By subtracting 0 from 8 we will get minus 8. Then minus 8 is not equals to 5. Therefore the equation is not satisfied. So students, if the value of H is 0, then H minus 8 is not equals to 5. So here the equation is not satisfied. Therefore, we will write no. Now, M and O part of question number 2, you have to do by yourself. Now, P part of question number 2, P plus 3 is equals to 1, where the value of variable P is minus 1. Solution for P part of question number 2, where the P plus 3 is equals to 1, it's given in the question and the value of the variable P is minus 1. Here in the place of P we will write minus 1. So P plus 3 means minus 1 plus 3 is equals to 1. If we add minus 1 with 3 we will get 2, as minus plus is minus. So 3 minus 1 will be 2. So 2 is not equals to 1. Therefore the equation is not satisfied. So students, if the value of variable P is minus 1, then the equation P plus 3 is equals to 1 is not satisfied. So here we will write answer as no. Q part of question number 2 you have to do by yourself. Students, with this we end our today's video and will continue with our chapter in the next video. Thank you.